happening, man? It's your boy, Him at Life 44, back with another video, you dig? Today we got something special today, man. I ain't never did one of these. I know y'all seen the thumbnail already. Y'all know what it is, but I never did one of these. Never drove them, never said them, none of that. So this is the first for me. But yeah, man, we got this 2019 Challenger GT, man. Y'all know how it is. You know what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna give you the walk around. But before I do that, you know what I mean? Y'all subscribe to my follow me on Instagram, Him at Life 44. No spaces or nothing. Just run it all together, Him at Life 44. Follow my car club page, MO underscore power, POWR underscore car, CAR underscore club. You know what I mean? Y'all do that for me, man. We got a lot of things going, man. We got a lot of things going and coming, you dig? But yeah, man, we're gonna get straight to this review. If y'all new to the channel and you like what you see after all this, subscribe. But if you don't subscribe, just go and hit that like button anyway for me, you know what I mean? But I appreciate if you subscribe, hit that like button, comment, all that good stuff. You know what I mean? It'll help you, boy. And it'll help you if you like seeing these good videos. This is gonna help you because I got them coming, people. You dig? But anyway, let's get straight to it. I noticed on the new 2019s, got the Challenger right here. You got it. I don't know if the other ones had it, but it didn't have this emblem on it. It's a new emblem. Then you come on this side, you got the GT right there. You got the GT. As y'all can see, I still got the lights on. Got the fog lights on the bottom. Nice grill. Boom. That's what I noticed first when I pulled up and seen this car. On the GTs, they put these hoods on her. On the 2019 V6s, they put these hoods on her. That's a good and a bad thing, you know? We'll get to that, though. I like these new rims. New rims, nice. I like them. Y'all see this, that Destroyer gray. Looking real good. It's kind of dirty, though. You know what I'm saying? It's kind of dirty. 245 tires. Everything's still the same, pretty much. Ain't nothing too much change. Clay Cooley, man, y'all come holler at them, they get you right, man. We're gonna pop this trunk. So y'all, this trunk is like, that trunk is huge for a two-door car. This car is big for a two-door, but you get a lot of space back there. When I had my Challenger, man, I had 212s back there, big pro box, and still had a little trunk space. So yeah, man, you get a little space back there. Go around, everything's still the same on the outside, man. Everything's still the same, but the hood, like I said, these come with the little things on it, the yellow things. You know what I'm saying? 2019. Pop this hood, though. So, yes, it is a V6. The GT is a V6, but we'll get to all that and talk about the G6. I mean, the GT. V6 when we get in. That hood scoop is still functional, though. Don't get that twisted. But yeah, man, it's pretty much everything the same, man. Everything the same. We ain't gonna do no startup because it's a V6. Ain't no point. You ain't gonna hurt nothing. You know what I mean? Boom. Yeah, that's it, though. Everything the same. But that scoop, I love that, man. I love it. That's crazy. I love that. Got the black top. Of course, the black top package come with the black fuel cap. It's gonna come with these rims. It's gonna come with the black spoiler. That's what the black top come with. This, that, and the black rims. And sometimes they come with the black rally stripes. So
That's what you get when you get a black top package. And this is the black top.
Let's get in.
As you can see, base model seats. Get my keys out the way. Basic seats, man. Everything basic in here. But which ain't bad. It ain't bad because everybody can't afford all the other ones. So, you know what I mean? Everything basic. I don't even know if this one have heated and cooled seats. Most likely it don't. Somebody tore the paper up, man. Look at there. Somebody tore the paper up. Somebody had their kids in the back seat probably. But you see the price on this one, $32,000. That's the base model price. So it's pretty much base, $32,000. We'll give y'all a rundown, see what this one come with. Feel free to pause it at any moment. Feel free to pause it. Optional equipment. Let's see what's in here. Twin C. That's the rims. The satin black rear spoiler. That's pretty much the whole blacktop package. Gloss black grill, gloss black instrument clusters. You know what I mean? That's what that is. That's the blacktop. Sears radio. You know, that's pretty much all you get. But anyway. Yeah, Challenger over there. You got the Sport, of course. Everything the same here, man. You got the compartment USB ports down there. Cigarette lighter or whatnot. You know what I'm saying? Cup holders on the side. You ain't got no Alpine sound system in here. You just got the regular speakers. Might not sound too good. I didn't like them. But, yeah, man. That's pretty much it. I'm going to start it up. And on this, oh man, come on, stop beeping. There you go. Then on the radio, in this one, you get that, I want to say that's a 6.4. Something like this, a smaller radio. But you still get the backup camera. You got the backup camera. Turn this AC off. You got the backup camera, man, but you ain't got navigation, which you can, I think you can, well, I don't know if you can still have navigation on this smart radio. I don't think they come with navigation, but you got the backup camera, you got Apple CarPlay, you got Android CarPlay, whatever y'all use, you Android people. Yeah, man, but that's pretty much it. You don't really need the navigation because if you got Apple CarPlay, if I had my charger, I'd show you. When you hook your charger up, boom, everything pop on your phone. You use your phone. Use the app on the phone and boom, you got the navigation right there on the screen. So you don't need no navigation. But that's pretty much it. It's base model. Got the lights and all lit over here. It's 9 miles on this joint. You dig? But yeah, man, we're gonna go and drive it back. See how the GT ride. Talk a little bit about this GT. Yeah, so we're gonna go and drive this thing. Safety first, people. Safety first, man. You know how I do it. Oh yeah, man. I know y'all probably just seen that when I turned around. But yeah, it's a new look. New look for me, man. Yeah, it is. You know what I'm saying? I done had this hat on, kind of messed my hair up or whatever, but yeah, man, fade fresh, man. Anyway, back to the car though. We're gonna drive this thing. See what this thing do. Turn this traction control off and see what's popping with it. You dig? See what's popping with this traction control. Let's see. Because if y'all don't know, the GT is an all-wheel drive vehicle. It is an all-wheel drive. I don't know if I can burn out on this. Oh yeah. That's a little different though. That felt like all four wheels was burning. I ain't got no controls or something. But, yeah, man, the GT is an all-wheel drive Challenger. So, with that being said, it's going to handle a lot better in certain conditions. Rain, sleet, snow, all that. It's going to handle better than a rear-wheel drive or a front-wheel drive car wheel. Because this is all-wheel drive, you dig? But and that's one reason I ain't waiting on you. You gonna have to wait on me, brother. But that's one reason why these GTs run so much. This is the cheapest GT I seen at $32,000. I had never seen a base model GT
I didn't even know they came base model like this. But this the, why is this light on? Okay. It's the cheapest base model I seen. I mean, cheapest GT I seen. I didn't know they came like this. But I guess so. Most of them come with the suede seats, like the Daytonas, them type seats. They come with them. I don't know if they, yeah, they come with those type seats. The suede seats. They always was a little different from the regular V6s. For one, if you could tell, a GT sit up a lot higher than a regular V6. Now on this one, on this 2019 one, I couldn't tell that. But on the 2018s and the other ones that I seen, they sit a lot higher. And that's because they're all-wheel drive. I ain't too much like that on them. That's one thing I didn't like, how they sit up so high. I ain't like that. But yeah, as far as the driving, I can't really tell no different. I guess you would have to wait till you in some type of conditions where it'll make a difference. You know what I mean? Like how it drives, it supposed to handle better in wet conditions and all this and that. So I'm guessing you would have to wait till you in a condition like that to see what the difference is. But right now, it just feel normal. Feel like I'm in a regular type whip right now. But man, I'm not even gonna say I like it because it's too base model for me. I reviewed this car for the people that don't care about, like, it's a lot of people that don't care about what the seats look like. They don't care about none of that. So you know what I'm saying, that's why I chose to review this car, to let y'all see, you know what I'm saying, that y'all can still on the outside get that SRT look. You know what I mean? You like the whip? Yeah. Hey, looking over here at the whip. But yeah, that's why I reviewed the car, to let y'all get a glimpse. Like, you 2019 Dodges, some of the 18s, they done start putting these SRT packages on her. You know what I'm saying? You throw you some tint on it. You know what I'm saying? Now you got you you look like you driving an SRT. Just don't try to race nobody, because you will get in bad wrists. But yeah, this ain't, 305 horses. It ain't doing too much. The whole truck right here in the middle of the road. Wow. Yeah, 305 horses, man. You ain't gonna get a lot out of it. But it still move for what it is. It's a V6. It still move to get down. You know what I'm saying? It's a girl in our car club got a V6 Challenger. We was on our way to our meet one day. I'm talking about, she right there with us the whole time. But I mean, she know I drive that thing too. But she right there with us. You know what I'm saying? These cars are due like 100 and... I got mine to 130. And it could have went some more. I just ran out of room. So, I mean... Man, you can... You know what you're doing, man. You can keep up a little bit. A little bit. But, yeah, man. It's a... I mean... You got the look, though. You got the SRT look. For a cheaper price. If you don't care nothing about the speed and all that... You don't care nothing about the speed and, you know what I'm saying? Pretty much for the ladies, y'all be the ones that be really into these cars. Let me try to hit it one time. I'm going to charge it right behind me. Got up to 80 right there. Got up to 80 real quick, you know what I mean? But something light. But I mean, hey, 32,000. 32,000. You got you a nice brand new car that's riding good. You know what I mean? You got the muscle look to it. You know what I'm saying? You can add your little own little wicker bill and all this other type little nicks and nacks, little cheap stuff. You know what I'm saying? And have it looking real ferocious. Or you can add something up under the hood and make it get down a little bit. But me personally, I wouldn't buy it. For a simple fact, I'm too into cars for a base model car. I'm too into it. So, but man, 32,000, man, it ain't bad though. It ain't bad. It ain't bad at all. This Destroyer gray looking real ferocious. But yeah, man, you know I'm finna go jump right in another whip right now. Bring y'all something else. You did. But yeah, man, y'all come out here, Clay Cooley, get this car, man. $32,000 if you want it. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, GT, 2019 Challenger GT, all-wheel drive. Just like the Trackhawks, all-wheel drive. Nice whip. I like it. I like it. I don't like the insides. Looking at it, I like it. I'm a Challenger fan. I like it. Gonna wrap this video up. Y'all like the car? Come out here and check it out, man. $32,000. Tell them him is like 44 cents. You know what I'm saying? They'll clear you up. Ain't the car nice? They'll clear you up, give you a great deal, and at the same time, if you really rock with me, you helping me out too. Cause I get a little something off that. Oh yeah, yeah, y'all do that. Make sure y'all subscribe to the channel. Make sure y'all hit that like button. Hit that notification bell so you'll be notified every time I post a video. Y'all come in. Let me know what type of cars y'all want to see. You know what I'm saying? Because like I said before, I'm out here picking the cars that I think people interested in. You might be interested in a little Malibu or something. And I can go jump in there right now. So y'all let me know what type of cars y'all interested in, what type of cars y'all trying to buy, y'all want to know something about. I can review that for you. But for the most part, man, I just be picking cars I be thinking people be interested in, you know. So y'all come in, man. Let me know where I can improve. Hey, I listen, man. So I'm not that type big headed. Even if once I get 200,000 subscribers, I ain't the type to get big headed at all, man. I don't do that type of stuff. I keep it 100 at all times. I listen. I'm willing to take advice. If I'm wrong about something, or if I can improve on something, I'm gonna tell you, appreciate it. I'm gonna work on it straight up. But yeah, man, y'all make sure y'all do all that. Subscribe, hit the like button, hit the notification bell so you be notified every time I post. Y'all comment, share my video, please. I can't stress that enough. Please share the video if you don't mind. You know what I'm saying? But y'all know how I end my videos, man. 1, 2, 3. In the meantime, in between time, to the next video, holla at your boy, man. I'm out. Ha!